summer camp. Today, when Gattu and Chinky came home from school, they seemed happy for some reason. And when Mummy saw their smiling faces, she asked them,
"Hey, Gattu Chinky, both of you seems to be in a good mood today.
Gattu and Chinky put their school bags on their study table and excitedly started explaining to their mother the reason for their happiness.
"Mummy, today our class teacher announced in the class that the school is taking us on summer camp this Friday.
And this summer camp will be in Lonavala."
"Wow, summer camp. I heard it's a lot of fun. And you also get to learn a lot of new activities. But for how many days are you going to Lonavala?"
"Mummy, the summer camp is for 3 days, Friday to Sunday. And the school has arranged some special buses to take us and bring us back from Lonavala.
I have only gone to school picnics till now. This will be the first time I'm going to a summer camp."
"Attending a summer camp in your school days is very important for your overall growth and learning. I'm sure you guys will enjoy."
At night, while having their dinner, Gattu and Chinky told their papa that they are also going to a summer camp. And he also enthusiastically encouraged Gattu and Chinky to attend the summer camp. On Friday morning, all the kids reached the school with lots of excitement. The special buses were already present, which would take them to Lonavala. All the children and 4 school teachers who were accompanying them kept their bags in the bus and started their journey. Within a few hours, the bus left the city behind and speeded up on the highway. And here children in the bus started playing Antakshari. All the boys created a team and the girls created another team. Both teams had some amazing singers in them and they enjoyed playing the Antakshari. Very soon the bus reached the hilly area where only high mountains and deep valleys could be seen besides the road.
"Wow, the scenery is so amazing. The mountains are so high and the valleys are so deep.
I am feeling dizzy just by looking at it."
"Chinky, don't look out of the window for too long when there is a valley."
The bus kept moving towards Lonavala through winding roads over the mountains. And by then, kids have stopped playing Antakshari and were enjoying the view outside their windows. After some time, they reached the resort in Lonavala, where the summer camp was organized. All the children got off the bus and stood near a big hoarding. On that hoarding, it was written, "Welcome to the summer camp." Sports teacher Mishra sir was given full responsibility for this trip. He told the children,
"Kids, your summer camp has been organized in this resort. And our chief instructor during this whole period will be Mr. Ravindra Sathe."
Mr. Ravindra Sathe, who had a big mustache and a domineering personality, stepped forward and shook hands with Mishra sir.
"Hello children, welcome to the summer camp. We have planned many activities for you in this camp, where you will have a lot of fun and you will also get to learn something new."
Sathe sir had attended military training and that is why his methods of fitness and training were exciting. First, he took all the kids for rock climbing. Behind the resort, there were some dense trees surrounding a big rock.
"Children, we have to climb to the top of this rock. You will notice some hollow shapes and raised stones on this rock. With the help of them, you can pull yourself up while climbing."
"And what is this helmet and rope for?"
"This helmet and rope are for our protection. If by chance your foot slips while climbing, you will not fall down due to this rope tied to you."
"Got it."
"Now you have to watch me carefully how I am climbing up."
With great skill, Sathe sir put his legs on the stones and started pulling himself upward while maintaining his balance. And in no time he reached the top of that rock. Now the kids wore the safety gears and helmets and climbed the rock one by one. After rock climbing, they went for commando net climbing. There also Sathe sir taught the children the basic technique. And after that, all the kids enjoyed commando net climbing one by one.
"You know, while doing this net climbing, I am feeling like a Spider-Man."
"Yes, this activity is really very fun."
All the kids were tired after rock climbing and commando net climbing. Children went to their room in the resort and took a rest for 2 to 3 hours. And then they came down to the dining hall for dinner. After dinner, Miss Prerna conducted a music workshop for them. In the auditorium, she gave all the children some basic knowledge of music.
"Now I will tell you about the notes and pitch of the music.
Chinky and some other students like her were enjoying this workshop a lot, as music was their hobby. After the workshop was over, Miss Prerna took all the students out in the garden, where a campfire was already burning. All the students and teachers sat around the campfire.
It feels so good to sit around the fire on the cold nights like this. I have seen campfires only in movies, and it feels great to experience them in real life.
Then Miss Prerna selected 5 students for a music competition on the basis of activities conducted in a music workshop, where they had to sing songs with difficult notes and pitch, and Chinky was among these 5 students.
All the best, Chinky. I'm sure you will be performing great.
Chinky sang her song with her full attention, and Miss Prerna was very impressed with her talent. After the competition was over, Chinky was declared the best singer, and she was awarded a medal. Everyone applauded for Chinky. On the second day of the summer camp also, there were many activities conducted that children experienced for the first time. First thing in the morning, Sathe Sir took all the students to a lake. Surrounded by the mountains, the water of this lake looked captivating, and on the shore there were a lot of kayaks.
Children, all of you will have to wear safety jackets and then learn the technique to row the kayak carefully.
Then Sathe Sir demonstrated to them how to paddle the kayak, which will help it to move forward, backward, and on both sides. Then many students took the kayak into the lake and started kayaking. Gattu and Chinky were scared a little bit at first, but after some time when they got confident, they enjoyed kayaking a lot. When the children returned to the resort, Mishra Sir made a new announcement.
I am very sure that all of you must have enjoyed kayaking very much.
Yes, sir.
Very good. Now we have arranged 3 different workshops for all of you. Acting, clay modeling and cooking. You can attend any of these workshops according to your interest in that field. We have invited specialists from those fields to conduct these workshops.
Gattu selected an acting workshop as he was interested in acting for a long time. Workshop's instructor was Mr. Puneet Sahani, who had performed in many plays for the Prithvi Theatre in Mumbai. Gattu learned acting and dialogue delivery from him, whereas Chinky was interested in clay modeling. She used the tips that she learned in the workshop and made beautiful clay toys. 2 days passed like this, and today was the last day of the summer camp. When all the kids went to the dining hall to have breakfast, there was a big surprise waiting for Gattu and Chinky. Their mummy papa were standing in front of them.
Papa, mummy, when did you come here?
Today being Sunday was a holiday, so we also decided to come to Lonavala. When your summer camp gets over, our whole family will go for a long drive and then we will return to our home.
This is a very nice idea.
Chinky and Gattu talked to Papa Mummy about all the activities they did in summer camp. Chinky also showed them the medal she won in the music competition. Papa and Mummy were very happy after seeing it. Summer season. It was a summer evening. Gattu and Chinky were playing football on the playground along with Bunty and Goody.
Come on, Chinky. Pass the ball to me.
Take this, Gattu.
Chinky kicked the football very hard, but Bunty managed to stop it midway.
Nice try, Chinky. But now the ball is all mine. Hey, Bunty, pass the ball to me. Goody, take this.
Hey, look over there. Kulfi seller is here.
All the children forget about their game and rushed to buy Kulfi. Everyone bought kulfi and returned to the ground. Then they sat down to enjoy it.
This kulfi is so cold. This is very tasty. I really enjoy eating kulfi.
Yes, our old tiredness is gone.
And after eating this, we are not feeling hot as we did earlier, right? Yes, you are absolutely right, Goody.
All the kids enjoyed eating kulfi. And then they returned to their homes. After reaching their home, Gattu Chinky searched for their mummy.
Mummy, mummy, where are you?
Yes, guys, I'm here in the kitchen. Go wash your hands and legs and freshen up. I am cutting chilled mangoes for you.
Wow, Mommy! We will freshen up in no time.
Then Gattu and Chinky quickly washed their hands and legs. Then they started enjoying cold mangoes while watching TV. The cooler was turned on and Gattu and Chinky were taking turns to sit in front of it.
Wow, these mangoes are so sweet and juicy, right?
Yes, Gattu, you are right. These mangoes are really very sweet.
Now move aside, Chinky. It is my turn to sit in the front of the cooler now.
Gattu, please give me 2 more minutes, then I will move away.
Oh, hurry up, Chinky. I also want to enjoy cool air from the cooler, Chinky.
Okay, Gattu, now it's your turn. Come and sit in front of cooler.
Wow, this is so good. Sitting in front of the cooler and eating cold mangoes is an amazing experience.
Gattu and Chinky started laughing out loud. In the evening also, it was very hot and Gattu Chinky were soaked in sweat. As a solution to this problem, both of them asked Mummy to fill the swimming pool with water.
Mummy, will you please fill a swimming pool with water? The temperature is so, so high today. It will be fun if we spend some time in the swimming pool.
Yes, Mummy, please fill the swimming pool quickly. I can no longer tolerate this heat anymore.
Alright guys, why not? I will go and get your swimming pool ready now.
Then Mummy quickly filled the swimming pool. Gattu and Chinky wore their swimming costumes and jumped into the swimming pool with a splash.
Wow, this is so good. The water of the swimming pool feels so cool.
Aha, it feels like all the heat has disappeared from here.
Gattu was enjoying his time in the swimming pool when Chinky targeted Gattu with her water gun.
Hey Chinky, what are you doing?
How do you like it, Gattu? See? This is my super gun, which will drive the heat away.
Your gun is really good, Chinky.
In this way, Gattu and Chinky enjoyed their time in the swimming pool for a very long time. And Mummy was glad to see that they were happy. After some time, she called both of them.
Gattu, Chinky, now come out of the swimming pool, guys. Don't spend too much time in the water. The sun has already set and very soon it will be night.
Then Gattu and Chinky stepped out of the pool and went to change their clothes. After changing into dry clothes, they went into their balcony and were waiting for their papa. It was a night and the sky was very clear. In the summer season, you can see the stars in the sky very clearly. Gattu and Chinky were looking at the stars. Then Papa returned.
Oh wow kids, were you guys waiting for me to come home?
Yes, Papa, you're right.
Yes, Papa, we were waiting for you only.
Oh, really?
Then Gattu rushes and brings a glass of water for Papa.
Here, Papa, drink water. You must be very tired.
Yes, Gattu, I'm really very tired. It is very hot outside. Now tell me, what you guys did today?
We ate kulfi today. And we also played with our friends, Gattu and Bunty.
Yes. And we ate chilled kulfi and sweet mangoes.
Then we played in the swimming pool. Today was a very nice day, Papa.
Very good. I'm very happy to hear that. It seems like you guys had a lot of fun today.
Come on guys, all of you, let's have dinner.
Come on guys, Mummy is calling us for dinner.
Then all of them sat together and started eating. After some time, Papa looked at Chinky. She was removing cucumber and tomato from her plate and keeping it aside.
Chinky dear, what are you doing? Why are you not eating salad?
Papa, I don't like all these vegetables at all. I don't want to eat them.
Chinky, do you know how important eating cucumber and tomato is for our body in the summer season? In the summer season, water evaporates from our body at a very high pace. And our bodies may get dehydrated due to lack of water. So we have to eat vegetables and fruits that have lots of water in them. These cucumber and tomatoes are full of water. And this way it fulfills our body's water requirement. So you have to eat salad in the summer.
Yes, Chinky, Papa is absolutely right.
Okay, Mummy, now I got it, Papa. Now I will eat cucumber and tomatoes every day.
Then Chinky finished her meal completely. And after they finished their meal, they were watching TV together. After that, Mummy brought mango shakes for everyone.
Wow, Mummy, mango shake. It's very nice.
Nice. Today we are going to have mango shake as a dessert. Very good. Now this is a real dessert.
Now stop talking and let's drink our mango shake quickly.
Wow, mommy. This shake is so tasty. It is really very nice.
Yes. Nothing can beat mangoes in summers.
Yes, kids. This mango shake is really very tasty.
Mommy, will you make mango shake tomorrow also? And then day after tomorrow too? And then throughout the summer?
Everybody starts laughing at Gattu's demand. And Gattu also joined them.
Yes, my dear, why not? I will make this tasty, tasty mango shake for you every day. Okay?
If you are liking our videos, then like them, comment them, and subscribe.